All right. Now I have my inability to drive. I can prove it. I got to the point where I knew that when over and I did win. Just, what is going to happen? I was playing tennis and I got this idea that I was playing much better when I wasn't thinking what I'm doing. And then I learned it's called the zone. All the players play the best when they get into this zone and everything works for some. And then in the moment when you're out of it, try to get back, you can't. And you see tennis players losing a match at the end of it while they were winning just because something happened in your mind. You cannot control. The harder you try, the worse it makes it. So I know what I have to do, but I know also that it's like for now what I'm happy with, I can go comfortably in and out of the first round, which was something I struggled for so many years that I'm ashamed of.
Everybody struggles with that.
Really?
So maybe I'm not that bad. I was like, when you get in and out of the foot straps, it affects the balance of the board and everything changes.
I know that now, and I know how to do it without affecting it or compensating for it, right? I'm just putting it downwind and I'm bending my knees down, sitting down there. Don't hurry, just put your right heel, I push a little bit with the heel. I sort of slide my back foot in as opposed to just taking it off and putting it in, which is unbalanced. Everything has to be done like smooth. But, and I knew that. But every time I got to the speed, I was, I think, afraid to do it. I was just, I just want to be in the footsteps, and it doesn't work like that. Or I didn't want to go fast enough to go in the footsteps because it looked dangerous to do it when it's fast. Same thing, everything. But I'm happy with the fact that I could. And I think I have to buy a helmet because I got this with some other stuff I bought and it's too small for me and it's absolutely excruciating. So I maybe sell this or give it to somebody as a gift that has a smaller head than I have. Buy a proper one because I was like, damn, my head is hurting. So, did you try the 45 degrees?
No.
It works. It works. I'm gonna patent it. It's a very good light.
Especially that I just put in with some of my ex-co-workers.
Everybody's having a good time out there.
That are sitting there.
Oh, this boat out here?
Living the same nice life.
It's so,
I'm a little bit mean, but I like to think about that.
That's one of the guys out there. He likes to fish too out here. As Jerry was telling me that.
They didn't do that out?
And apparently, I don't know that today, this board with this thing, just the way it should be, I don't know, for some reason. Sometimes even when you go one way and you come back, it's not like, you feel comfortable one way, you don't feel comfortable the other one. Something is not, probably the wind got a little bit different. Did that happen to you too?
Yeah. First of all, your posture can be different.
Yeah, because everybody...
Another thing that happens, people tend to go upwind more one way than the other way.
Yeah, so that they...
Depending on what they can see and the colors of it. And then, you know, just a half an inch on the harness line can make a difference too.
Yeah, this one today is just magic. Everything was like, boom, left, in, out, in, out, and one.
That was my review. I had that this morning.
Thank you very much for fixing it for me.
And
how did you know my...
You had the 110 and the 5...
110 and the 5.4, yeah.
5.4 or 5.0?
5.4. The only thing I had to do, I had to lift it up and probably...
I had the 5.0.
Somebody had it, I had the boom much lower. But it's like...
I like that 110.
The 110? It's perfect. And
I had the 1.5 and I gave it away because, I mean, I sold it for almost not because I thought it's too small for me.
Well, I got the 5.3,
yeah. On the other hand, it was a mixed trout, so the shape counts too.
The JP trout is really quite nice to sell.
Yeah, right. Very nice. Here. Just eat. And then complain in the morning about your muscle pain. Do you use the roller foam? Have you ever used the roller foam? I have very bad back problems. And physiotherapist recommended me some exercises with a roller foam. I always carry it with me. This time I bought a version that's for traveling, which is shorter and narrower, but it's not good enough. So it's a tube about this height. About this diameter. You put it along your spine and you roll left and right. Then you switch it and you roll forth and back, forth and back. You can roll and massage any muscle on your body. And then there's a number of specific exercises that I do to keep my core muscles strong, because that's the reason why I got the back pain, because when the small muscles that are connected to the vertebrae become weaker, and the bigger one try to take that, but they're not as versatile, and then all of a sudden you cry. And you get all this. 1.5 months I was in bed. Couldn't get up. I didn't want to take any painkillers, didn't want to go to the doctor, because all they give you is painkillers, and they recommend your surgery. But they see something there, which was there for 20 years, it's just that it happens that they see it only now, because now it's when you went there. Before you do what? I don't have a problem ever since then. I play tennis, which unbalances you a lot. So I think for windsurfing, they are magic because you roll your back, you roll your hamstrings on them. And my hamstrings tend to get tense. And then it pulls on a pelvis, right? And you get back pain.
My hips rotate.
Yeah. So if you go, and it's about $40, I think. That lasts for years. And I do it 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes in the evening, that's it. But you go and you're stiff in the morning and you start rolling on it, and it's like 80% of the stiffness is gone. And before, you would try to stretch and it wouldn't move. You need a massage, but then you pay $100 for an hour.
My wife and I work on each other's back, and she can easily tell if my hips are rotating. And she'll work the muscles out on each side, and my back will crack.
She's a chiropractor. Yeah, it's a lot of cramping muscles that are doing that, and people think, oh, I have, I don't know what.
It's a matter of getting the muscles in the right condition and getting things aligned and things popped, and you're off and going.
My feeling that I had a muscle problem and not a, you know, column problem was that I felt slightly better if I took a hot shower. And that tells you it's a muscle.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the bone is, the thing is very, very, but the muscle relaxes a bit, and that's what.
All right, I'll be here tomorrow. You know what a naturopath is?
What?
Naturopath?
No idea.
It's a blend between a chiropractor and a massage therapist. They'll go in and look for those misalignments, and they don't know how to work those muscles back, and they just seem marvelous.
Yeah, I have to maybe smile a good one, because you're saying, I mean, when I came to Canada in 96, that's why I was reluctant to visit them. There was a story with a lady that they cracked her neck, and then she died. That's right.
I'm
coming from Eastern Europe, still Europe, right? The only resemblance to a chiropractor was the elder woman of the village without a doctor, because that's what happened in those villages. There was an old woman that kind of knew how to put your bones back when you have a luxation or something that's not broken, right?
I'm thinking, what the heck is that? That's a chiropractor. I never heard one. Is it a doctor or is it not a doctor? So I didn't get the habit of going there. Maybe it's good, maybe it's bad. I'll stick with my own. Because that story was nice, right? You go there, you go to the factory, you can only die later. So. Because I'm thinking it's very dependent on the way you have. Yeah, they get better, but it's like anybody else. Some people are really. I don't want to go to the one that's like me. I don't want to go to the chiropractor that says it's a bad analysis.
We see them a lot, all summer long. Sure,